product that somebody might have sitting close to them and a pair of speakers next to that or on a shelf. And sometimes you might want to listen to headphones. And with the headphones, and I have them here, I'll play something for you. And I'll play it. And unfortunately, I can't pass the headphones along. But if you were to have this working, and you're listening to music, and you're sitting on your chair, and the music's playing, and your wife says, hey, turn it down or something, and you still want to hear it, and you don't want to move, you can put your headphones on. And you hold whatever input is, that's the right input middle, I can hold this remote, and now the headphones are on. You can maybe hear them way in the background. So now you have headphones, and you haven't had to move from your chair at all. So that's one of the things it does, and you just hold it back on. The other thing that people sometimes, I mean, I like the way my display looks with the meter, because I like to see where the volume control is from a far distance, and that's very convenient, and the light's on all the time, you can't turn it off. But if you don't like it, we have a system called dark mode. So if you hold the input button in, now when it turns on, now it'll go off, and that's off. And until you move something, it goes back on, and then it goes off. So that's if you don't like the light. Personally, I like the light. So let's talk a little bit about some of the stuff that's in there. There's tone controls. Why doesn't everybody put tone controls on their preamp? Because way back a long time ago, a guy in Connecticut, United States, Mark Levinson, said tone controls are bad. And overnight, tone controls disappeared from all preamps. But I remember when I was young in audio, I had a Marantz 7C and a Marantz 8B, and I liked to use the tone controls on different records. I enjoyed it. But going back there, I understand why the Mark Levinson company didn't like the tone controls the way they were applied, because they were always in the circuit, even if they were off. So I said, well, how can you do tone controls and not make them be part of the system? So if you turned on the tone control, the sound would not change except of where you wanted it, on the low and the high. So I said, how could I do this without using the circuits that are already in the preamp? So I started to think about it, and I said, very easy thought. I will just design another board that has the input board already, a second input board that's just for the tone control. So I call it the tone amplifier, and it's made up of the same types of components that are on the input board. So when you turn on the tone control on this, it's essentially bypassing the original input board and going through the tone control board, which is exactly the same board. But now you can control the tone with it. The tone control board not only has a separate path, but it also has a separate regulator and power supply. So it's totally separate from the preamp, because I wanted no one to say, oh, tone controls are bad. So what I'm going to do for you is I'm going to put some music on, and I'm going to switch the tone control in and out, so you know that the place that you listen to most of the music from is not affected at all, and you will not hear a change. So I'm going to put these controls on zero.
At least I think I am. There we go.
Okay, so we'll play some music. What happened? Oh. Okay, I'm going to put the tone control on. It's on. It's off. So you see, there's no coloration in the middle part of the music that you listen to. So when you use the tone control, only thing that's affecting is your, is the part that you want to be affected, but not the part you don't.